Right, hi everyone. Small little demonstration to help you understand how much luting cement should you be using at the time of cementing a crown. A small little contraption here. So this is the prosthetic crown and this is the abutment tooth. In order to create a small little illusion of what actually happens when you are loading a crown and placing it on top of the abutment tooth. So instead of the luting cement, what I'm going to use is light body because it has a similar flow consistency. So here I'm going to go ahead and fill only the base of the crown. Right, that's it. Appreciate that. This is very little amount of, say GIC, for example, that I have used, very little. What I'm going to do is I'm going to place this on top of the abutment tooth, just like I would in the patient's mouth, place it on top and then press the entire assembly together. What I want you to appreciate is see how beautifully the material is flowing, and we see some material extrude out as well. Right, what I want you to appreciate is see the uniformity of the flow in all directions. What I'm trying to help you understand here is that when you're luting a crown, make utmost attempts to have your luting agent towards the base of the crown, and you actually do not need to flood the entire crown with the luting cement, just a little, and provided your prosthesis has been properly made, see how beautifully the GIC or any other luting cement will flow and will hold the crown in place. Thank you.